I met Roger when we first put Steely Dan together and we were doing the first records. Roger's standard of recording was so high, he was almost obsessed.
He was a scientist and he was a brainiac. Every little detail added up to the quality of sound that he was looking to get.
You'd watch him and try and figure out, what is he doing? I'm working. And can I help? No.
It was like that.
Donald would come in and say, I want this tune to be perfectly steady. One of those was Showbiz Kids. Show business kids. And there was no really good drum machines, so we ended up just recording 8 bars. You can make this work out, right? You can loop this or do something. And I said, sure.
I remember walking in one day. Roger had made a loop, a drum loop, that went from the studio into the hallway over a chair. It went about, I would say, the equivalent of 4 different rooms. I had never seen anything like that before.
We were in the studio one day. Donald wasn't happy with a drum track, and he turned to Roger and said, can't you make a fucking machine that would be perfect?
I did build a machine to help things out, but the criteria was to, so that you couldn't tell at all that it was a machine.
We laughed about it. I mean, Donald and I would laugh about it, and Walter, you know, it wasn't gonna work. So when Roger came in with Wendel, which was, at the time, it was a big piece of gear, heavy, well, he plugged it in, and he turned the screen on. All this digital stuff is going on the screen, you know, flying by, you know, X's and O's and this. It was, you know, Star Trek.
He was able to write the software, an assembly language, the hardest of all. He had a computer that was capable of digitizing and then replaying drum samples.
There was no such thing as MIDI then. So we just put a click on tape, have the click trigger the computer, and then we'd have to go back and make a second pass and do the snare drum, another pass and do the hi-hat. Then we'd listen to all 3 of them together and say that, well, the kick drum needs to be earlier, the snare drum needs to be later, the hi-hat needs to be quicker, things like that, move them around, put each one down again, so it would take all day.
And being able to move each individual beat in almost inaudible amounts, that was, you know, like Nirvana. It was Nirvana for Donald.
The first thing that played on was Hey 19. Then when we did the Donald Fagen's Nightfly album, I built a new machine that was 16 bits, and we hooked it up to the 3M machine so it would transfer information digitally. You know, I built these things because it would take a lot less time than it would to be in the studio with Donald punching in one drum beat at a time or cutting the same tune, you know, 400 times with 400 different drummers. So Gaucho only took 2 years instead of, we might still be in the studio working on it.
Best engineered recording, Gaucho, Roger Nichols.
It's just been the attention to detail and also the desire to solve problems. Not really problems in that something's broken or something's wrong, but problems, gee, how could we do this? And push the envelope of technology a little bit, and it helped the production, and helped everything sound better. Compared to anything else at the time, they all sound really good, and there's not any one thing that I would do over again.